Hello everyone, it's me. I kind of want to do something different tonight. So I wanted to kind of pick a game that was maybe in my library for a while that I've wanted to play for you but haven't had a chance. Most of my channel revolves around picking LPs and then finishing them, you know, start to finish without any break. And I thought to myself, what if we tried to do something where we pick a game for one night, play it a little bit, see how we like it, and then if we do, maybe we could continue it as a series later on. So I decided to start with City Skylines. It's a game that I've really been enjoying lately. It's on Steam right now. A lot of people have given this very high ratings, and for good reason, especially after SimCity was so kind of disappointing. If you got involved in that whole thing, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. It's a city builder. It's very intuitive, actually, and I'm really kind of excited to start. Let's see here. You can choose from some maps, and I do have some custom maps available. There's nothing really special about them. They're just different places in the world. Nothing big there. This is going to be mostly vanilla, so no worries there. Let's try to do something cool. Maybe we can make something, I don't know, a place where I would like to live. I might start with either, I don't know, maybe we should start with the first one. I have no idea. Just to see what we could make. Green Plains, River Runs, Black Woods, Sandy Beach. There's a whole bunch. There's some that are islands. That's really kind of hard to start with. So maybe we should just start with something basic. Why not? Let's go ahead and do that. Green Plains? Oh, let's see what we got. Now, I've played this a little bit. Nothing intuitive. Like, I haven't made, like, a huge megapolis or metropolis yet. I just kind of been playing with it a little. So I wanted to mostly show you guys to see if it's something you would like. Here we are. So, the first thing you're gonna want to do is pause it so we can kind of look and see what we have going on here and what's available to us. Look at that. So, if you have played the latest SimCity, you'll know that a lot of people did complain because EA kind of made a lot of promises that weren't really kept. And one of the biggest qualms that I had and a lot of people had about that game was just the world was too small to make like a really full city. If you zoom out here, you can see that this is the entire map. Look at that. So right now we're only building on this one little plot in the middle of the map. But you have the possibility to unlock all of this and make your city like span through the whole thing. So they've already really improved on that. So it's really kind of cool. You can see there's already some highway put down here. This is the entrance where we will start. Some really pretty bridges and a lot of things. There's a lot of different climates, a lot of different kind of biomes that you can pick throughout the maps, and you can even make your own. So that's really cool as well. So the first thing it wants us to do is build roads. We have a budget of 70,000, you can see down there. I'm not sure what that is, if it's like simoleons or dollars or lira or, you know, anything. It could be anything. We could just call it ducats or donuts for all we care. So let's start. This game is a little bit akin to SimCity, where it literally will not let you do anything until you put down one single road. Like, we don't even have anything else unlocked here, just the first basic two-lane road. So what I do is I just plop one down anywhere and then just bulldoze it. That way, as you can see, we have more things open to us. So there's a couple of things we want to kind of work out right away. Let's see now. I'm not very good at planning cities, I'm just warning you now, so this is probably going to be like an abomination, but it'll be mine, so I'll cherish it. I don't know, I have a feeling that we're going to be making like some inappropriately shaped roads and things of that sort. But the first thing we need to figure out is where we would like the roads to come off the highway and go to. And another thing we need to plan is where we're going to put things once we do that. So there's a couple of things we want to look at. We have a little panel here where we can look at things like water. So this will show you, like, if you have water on your map, which way it's flowing. So as you can see, this is flowing this way. This is important because we're going to need to set up water and sewage, and we're going to need to know which way the water is going for that. The other thing I'm going to need is wind power. So we may be a little out of luck here because the wind seems to be concentrated right here in the middle. That's not the greatest thing ever, but I might be able to work around it depending on. It may be a little ugly for a while, but that's okay. Starting cities usually are. So it's not going to be anything like really great off the bat, but let's try it and see what we can do. So I'm already kind of thinking about what we're going to do. So the highway comes off two ways. This way goes up towards the highway, and this is coming off the highway down here. These are one-way roads. So we're going to have to figure out a way to connect them. And I think right now our best option, even though I don't like these myself, but it might be the best option now, is to do a small roundabout, like right here. And then what we can do, let's see, how are people going to get in here is what we got to figure out. If we bulldoze that, we could make, gosh, what could we do? Yeah, this should work, maybe? If we do two, one way, boom. So the one way roads will move in the direction that you place them. So if I move it from here down here, it'll go in that direction. Does that make sense? Let's try that. One of the biggest problems in this game is traffic, which we're not gonna have any problem with that until probably way later. But it is going to be a problem, trust me. So now we've got a nice cool roundabout. There's some really pretty trees in the middle. Look at that. It looks kind of nice. So people can just kind of come in and get a little dizzy as they come into our little neighborhood. And then maybe we should extend it along the water a little bit. How about that? Let's see. We don't want to go too far because we don't want to waste too much money on roads in the beginning. Let's look at that wind one more time. All right, so I'm going to use wind power, which means we're going to have to concentrate some things right in here. That's not great for map setup. However, we might be able to make it work, and I'm going to see if we can. Let's do this. First, we have to figure out what to call this place, but I'm going to think on that for a minute longer. Let's see. So the cool thing about this game is that you can build roads, obviously, straight. Very easy, like just as long as you want them. You can also build them curved, which is kind of nice. You can make nice, you know, nice bends, which I like to do. Or they added this thing where you can do kind of this like free for all, whoa, like real crazy. So you can make like winding roads and things like that. And it's really quite nice. Road building in this is amazing. I'm not very good at it. So if you see some crazy things happening, you're probably gonna yell. And get real upset. It's gonna be a thing, actually. I have a vision that we're gonna put a road going this way, okay, towards the water. And then I think we're gonna have like a T-junction here. This is shaping up already. I love doing things like this, I really do. Let's go a little bit more. Right to the border. And we'll make like a little block, just like that. Now you can see like the grid is where we can put zoning, but we're not quite ready for that yet. I'm gonna put one more junction here. I like that, that looks good. And then, let's see. What else? I think we'll have our industrial here, and then I think we'll have a residential come, let's see. Maybe we could have that curve over. We wanna keep it away from the industrial. If you've ever played any SimCity, you will know that it's kind of important to keep your residents away from any like pollution or noise or things like that. The problem is we're gonna have to, you know what, hang on, I don't like what I just did. We're gonna have to figure out like a good way to keep everybody away from the bad stuff. That's what we're gonna do. We don't want this to be like the ghetto. It's not good. I don't want to live in the ghetto. I want to live in like a really cool, like modern. Is this gonna work? God, I don't even know. We're already starting off badly because I have like no notion of what I should be doing. Let's make a curve that goes down here. I kind of fancy that we can make something like right here. Let's see. Will that work? We might have to redo all of this. Who the hell knows? So we want to keep it away from the wind area, but I think we can make a little block there where it would actually work. So let's try that. Let's do that right here. We'll make like a little block. We want to get it straight too. This is going to really piss off any OCD people because I don't tend to make these roads straight at all. We'll make a little thing here and oh wow, it's like it's all like uneven because I think we're on like a slight slant, so that's fine. Okay, so now we've got a small layout, and I think what we're gonna do, this tells you about all kinds of stuff, we'll go through that later. Let's see, what kind of town do we want to build? Heavy on industrial, heavy on commercial? We'll figure that out in a minute. The first thing we're gonna need is a water pump. Now this is where the water becomes important. This is going to pump water from the river or stream or whatever you have to the people. You want to make sure that you're pumping clean water, because we also need the shit pipe. Now, the shit pipe is going to do exactly what you think it's going to do. It's going to pull out all the sewage and the shit into the water. This is why we don't want to have it anywhere near each other. So I'm going to put the shit pipe away from the water pump, like here. And since the water's flowing downward, it should just take all the shit with it. You know, everyone's like Kleenexes and dirty tissues and, you know, their butt wipes and things like that. All you have to do to make it work is connect it to a water pipe. And then you can lay pipe through your grid area. This is going to be a little expensive for us at first because we're kind of far away from the residential. I'm actually wondering if we shouldn't make it closer. I think we may want to do that. I mean, maybe the first area we have could be like a little bit ghetto so that they're not all the way over here. I think we may have to. We might have to do that. You know what we could do? Is we could make a road. Here, let's try this. See, this is why, the reason I'm kind of bad at these games is not because I don't know how to build a city. It's because I'm incredibly indecisive in like all the ways possible. Like really bad. The worst, actually. So what we could do actually if we wanted is we could make, let's see, we could make a road coming down. This is probably gonna be so boring for you all, but I'm having fun, so I hope you are too. And if you want to, like, you know, keep going with this later and have like a discussion on how we want the city to progress, we could totally do that. We could have the commercial line here in front of the ship pipe, and then we could have like a beautiful little area here where there's going to be houses overlooking the river and the ship pipe. What do you think? I think it's actually a good idea. We could call it Ship Pipe Way. I think I like it. All right, so let's make a small block, like right here. And then we'll make, how many rows can we make? We can make one here. It's a little bit janky, but that's okay. We're starting out bad. You know, things aren't always the best at first. This looks fine. So now, we're going to want to connect the water pipes to here. We can do that through this. And then you make a small grid, and anywhere blue is obviously where the water will connect to. So you want to make sure that all your zoning has water and power. Very important. There we go. We're spending a lot of money, so we got to hurry up and get this. Now, we need electricity to power the water and the shit pipe, and also to give our homes electricity. So, unfortunately, we're going to have to shove them all the way out here. Holy crap. People are just going to wonder what the hell this lone wind turbine is doing all the way out here. It has no home, and it's a little bit weird that it's all the way out here. And then we're going to have to connect it. This map was probably not the best choice. But that's okay. We'll make it work. We will do it. We will make it work as best we can. So connect that to here, and then we can. This will be ugly at first. There we go. That will connect up to power. Now, let's start building. So now we can take it off pause. Twitter. It has its own Twitter and everything. So now down here is zoning, and it'll show you what we need. Green is high, so there's very high demand for residential. Congratulations, the city's first power plant has been constructed. I don't know if I would call this thing a power plant. It's kind of just sitting out here. Look at that. It's cool, isn't it? Well, they're happy with green energy. So you can see like what your citizens are talking about up here. We don't even have any citizens yet, but they're talking about it apparently. Maybe people just drove out to see like this lone wind turbine. And admire it. You know, he's a little lonely out here. But it's fine, actually. Don't worry about it. So let's start with some residential. We can put some here. Now, you can paint these zones in a couple of ways. You can go like this. You can draw it yourself. You can actually take a paintbrush and go like that. Or I like the big paintbrush myself. So we can kind of draw where we want the houses to come up. So let's try that. Let's do, I think maybe we should have like some like right here, right along here would be good. and see what happens. We may have to connect some energy a little closer. I'm not sure if it'll reach. The deal with energy is this like blue bubble is how long it reaches to, and this is the next one. So it looks like we have to kind of get it over here. Let's see if we can. It looks like it won't jump that far. Like I said, this is gonna be real ugly at first, but we can fix it later if we don't go bankrupt or burn the place down, which to be fair, I don't have high hopes. Look at that. People are already moving in. Oh, look. Here comes our first citizens, and we don't even have a name for this place. Let's name it quickly. Springwood is a nice name, but I don't like it. What should we call it? I don't even know, actually. I kind of want to call it... But I really should have come prepared. Kind of want to call it Shitsville, to be fair. Because these houses are overlooking that beautiful shits pipe. All right. Who am I to go with anything else? Shitsville. You know, look at beautiful little houses and cottages have come. Look at that. Aren't they pretty? And I have a little mod installed where you can kind of go into first person here and kind of go along the roads and see like what everything is doing. Ooh, look at the music picked up finally. I was wondering when it was actually coming. Oh, look, there's an apartment complex right here. Isn't that nice? Like little condos where people can go up to their rooftop garden and look at the shit pipe and admire it in all its glory. Look at that. That's beautiful, actually. I love it. This is going to be like the highlight. Like tourists are going to come from far and wide to see the shit's pipe. So isn't that nice? So let's see. We've got a couple houses now in Shitsville. We need a tiny bit of commercial. There's a little bit of demand and a little bit of demand for industry, but mostly for houses. So let's keep going with that and see what we can make. So let's have some more here, kind of like in the block, and see what comes up. The houses are generated at random. And one of the cool things you can do here is you can actually click on a house and see like what their name is. This is the Hickory residence. There's three adults and one children here. And then next we have the Daffodil residence. And you can name them all and kind of follow them around and see what they're doing. You can also see how your building is doing, who lives in it, and what it will take to level up the buildings. But we'll talk about that later. So look at this. Isn't that beautiful? Look at this scene here. Doesn't that look like a very nice like little suburb area? There's trees. Beautiful two-lane road with some lights. Overlooking a lot of power lines and the shit pipe. Oh, well, I mean, they've got a nice view of the bridge over there. That's pretty nice, actually. Not too bad. Look, we got some new houses coming up here. Got a little bungalow on the corner. Isn't that adorable? I love it. Well, this looks so nice, doesn't it? Shitsville is starting to become a thriving little community. Now, our needs have changed a little. So now we have some demand for some commercial zone. So let's put that down. So when you think of commercial zone, think of things like, you know, a grocery store or maybe a McDonald's or a Starbucks. Let's just put a little bit down and see what we get since we don't have a very high demand for it yet. And look, it's already building. Look at that. Let's see what we have. What is our first commercial building going to be? I can't wait to see it. Oh, isn't this exciting? It's the birth of a new city, and we're here to see it and take it over and rule. What is it? It looks like it's Sally's, some kind of department store, I wager, or a burger place, considering that they have like a really big billboard sign for a burger. But actually, it kind of looks like a vintage grocery store. I'm going to assume that that's what it is, since it has different little things that it's advertising on the side. So great. We have a grocery store in Shitsville. That's fantastic. And then what else do we have? We've got some other things coming up here. While those are building, we also need industrial. Now, people are going to have to take this little beautiful winding road under the power lines to get to the industrial, which is going to be over here, kind of separated from the houses. So let's do that. Let's put some industrial right here along the water area, you know, just a little bit, because industrial is going to be the main place right now where the people are going to work. So they're going to go to work at this industrial area. Maybe this could be like the industrial park. you know, lots of cities have those where you kind of drive around in a crazy maze. And it's nothing but factories and pollution as far as the eye can see. So every city needs one. We can't have just green, beautiful supermarkets forever, can we? Look, someone's already like taking their scooter through the industrial park just to see what's happening over here. It's already like coming up. All right, what do we got? Look at this. It looks like it's going to be a huge factory. I'm excited. Oh, a bunch of them actually are coming up right away. So when the demand for things are higher, they'll build usually right away and fairly fast. Look at that. We've got our first factory. It could be like a taco factory. Maybe that's what Shitsville will... maybe that's like its prime crop. its assets will be nothing but tacos. You know, because yeah, Shitsville tacos, it goes together. It's the city that will probably produce the most shit. So let's see, the ice cube factory. I don't think so. Well, I mean, ice cubes are kind of important. We could leave that, and then the box factory. We don't. No, we only make boxes here. That's a Simpsons reference, but it was a bad one. So let's go ahead and name this this is the tortilla shell factory. This is where they make the delicious tortilla shells that your tacos may come in if you're an American, because Americans like the crunchy tacos, and you know, those are usually kind of not authentic. Now look what we've got going on here. People are coming down the messed up. Oh, God, I just realized, you guys. I just realized what we've done. I didn't mean to do that, but there it is, in all its glory. So now everyone's coming down the old ding-a-ling roundabout here. And they're coming into Shitsville by way of this road, past the industrial park, and down to the residential area to move in. Isn't that wonderful? Now, when we get a little more money and more people, we can probably make like a bypass to go directly to the residential. But for now, this should be okay. We need a little more residential, but we have some blocked off. So let's just make a tiny bit more and see if it populates. And then it's saying we need much more industrial. So let's get that moving. Let's put some more right here across the street and see what other kind of factories we can get. Just paint a little, not too much at a time. I don't like to go too much at a time because sometimes I feel like these demand graphs are not always the most accurate. So I like to kind of do it manually and then see how it goes. We're on the slowest speed too right now. Like SimCity, this has like a slow and then like a fast and like a turbo speed for growth. But in the beginning, I think it's nice to watch it kind of build slowly, don't you? What do we have over here? Look at this. We have another department store and a Burger King. This may be copyrighted, but this is actually DLC that I got from the Steam Workshop. It was made by a fan. Isn't that wonderful? You know, one thing I'm kind of hoping that if this takes off as a series and you guys want to see more of this, that someone will go ahead and make me like, you know, some taco restaurants or, you know, taquerera, as they're called, I think, in Mexico, something like that. And then we can have them all over the city. Wouldn't that be fabulous? What do we have over here now? Ready to wear. Let's call this ready to bean incorporated. This is where all the beans are going to come from, like your black beans, pinto beans, and refried beans. They're all going to be fashioned right here for your taco pleasure and held right over here in this little shipping area. Those are just chock full of beans. Look at that. Those containers are just full of them. There's nothing else. All right, look at that. It's shaping up, isn't it? What a beautiful, picturesque setting. Look, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? We got the lonely turbine powering the city away over there by himself. And then just this lovely expanse with the mountains in the distance. Isn't that beautiful? Let's get some more housing because that's going to be a primary source of income for us right now. Now, I got to tell you guys, I'm really terrible at budgeting too. Bad. I like to build for the aesthetic reasons and I love to see everything grow. But with the budget and city planning, it's going to be a learning curve and we're probably going to learn it a little bit together because it's not my forte. I think a lot of people spend hours in this game just like planning cities, like building roads and planning like these crazy road structures that we'll probably see a little bit later if we want to continue. Look at that! A donut truck! Can we follow him? Oops. I didn't mean to do that. Let's exit out of that, shall we? Donut truck. Where are you going, sir? Look at that. They move a little fast, so you gotta be careful. Oh, he's dropping off donuts at the grocery store. Look at that. Did you guys see that? And then where's he gonna go after that? Who knows? You can actually follow him like this. Isn't that cool? And you can get like kind of, the first person doesn't work with the vehicles, but you can kind of follow them a little bit. Or you can click the little map icon and then follow them. There he goes. He's leaving. He's leaving Shittsville. The donut factory is not here in our town. It's probably in another town. So they're just going. They're leaving. There's nothing here for them to stay for. More housing. Let's get it done. Look at all these beautiful little houses we have. Guys, are you excited? Shittsville is starting to become a thing. I'm really, really excited about this. Now notice we haven't had to put any power lines down because, like I said, if you go to the electricity tab here, you can see that the electricity will bounce from house to house within a radius. So we're fine there. In fact, once we get all this commercial filled in here, we can take down these lines. We won't need them anymore. Lines do cause a bit of like visual and noise pollution, I believe, in this game, even though it's kind of not said. So I try to get rid of them ASAP so that it's not bugging my residents. I want them to be okay. God, look at these people. They've come to Shittsville with their hopes and dreams on the line. They're gonna try to make it. Look at this beautiful little community. Isn't this beautiful? Well, I would like to live here, actually, on the lovely river, the Shittsville River, that's having the shit. Look at this. If we did a picture like this right here, we could make a postcard. Well, oh, that's a little too close. Welcome to Shittsville. I think this should be like the postcard. What a beautiful place. Oh wow, the houses are populating very fast. That means the demand is very high still. So maybe we can actually get away with like doing this whole row. Let's see what happens if we do that. And, you know, as we level up, we'll get access to more services, things like parks and offices and really cool things that we can add to make our city a good one. So now we're in the green of our budget. We're making money I believe it's either day cycle or month cycle. Oh, no, weekly. I'm sorry. It goes pretty fast, though. So let's just see how we do. We want to get it in the green because we want to make money, obviously. We don't want our city to go bankrupt. It's too beautiful and too wondrous. Look at this. And, you know, as we build, we can kind of plan what we're going to do. I don't like that all of our power has to be situated right now in the middle of the map, but I think we're going to get some resources later that will help with that so that we don't have to necessarily do that and we can fill it with more things. All right, we're looking good. Houses are building. We've got some duplex houses, some beautiful single-family homes, little bungalows for people that like to live in, like, the small house community, you know, like the people that are really green and don't like to take up a big carbon footprint. Everybody is welcome at Shittsville. You know, oh, people are coming home. Look at that. Isn't that wonderful? It's a very quaint little hamlet. I think that's what you would call it at this size. I'm not sure. You can see the bustling traffic go by to bigger and better cities. You know, they may stop at Shittsville. They might. Look at all the people that are actually coming off the ding-a-ling roundabout and coming into our fair city. They definitely come to see the shit pipe. I mean, it's the look at. You can even hear. Oh God, look at how dark that shit is. People are already just shitting their pants completely, and we haven't even really started to make tacos. We really have only just started with the burger route. Maybe they're just trying it out, you know, testing it to see what kind of things we could get away with. Maybe they're gonna try a taco burger, who knows. It looks like we need a little more industrial, so let's just put a little bit more here and see what we get. We've already got the tortilla shell factory and the bean, the ready-to-bean, which is right here. Gosh, let's see what else we come up with here. Look, we've got the trucks coming in, bringing all the bean shipments out, maybe to other places. Maybe we could have like an export of beans, because, you know, maybe just other towns just are in desperate need of some pinto beans or possibly, you know, frijoles negros and, They need us. Look at that hot dog truck. Oh my gosh, look at that. That's clearly me moving in. I don't think they have taco trucks in this game. However, if somebody would love to add one, holy shit, I would put it in a second. Look at that. Where's he going? Where is he off to? The hot dog van delivering goods to the drugstore. Look at that. This is a drugstore over here, apparently. Isn't that cool? Wow. Well, we've got our own drugstore. We've got a shopping little plaza next to it. Oh, look at this. Look what we've got here. What do we got here? Another ready-to-wear? I don't think so. This is definitely Lettuce Incorporated. Lettuce Incorp. This is where the lettuce is is constructed. Because you gotta have some lettuce sometimes on your tacos. Not all of them need lettuce, but some do. So we'll have a little factory dedicated to lettuce, and there it is. I think it looks pretty good. Shitsville is really... Uh-oh. Now look, we've got a problem over here. Not enough power. When this happens, it means that they're getting brownouts. So let's look at our electricity panel. Now you can see that the consumption is 8, but we're only producing 8, which means that we are going to have brownouts. So the only way to get rid of this problem is to add another turbine. So what that means is, for the low, low price of 6,000... Oh god, we're really kind of getting low on money already. It's hard as you start out. I think we also started out with kind of a crappy map. So let's put it in a place where it'll get the most. I think 8 is the most that it will get. It will power itself next to this one. And look, now they're not alone anymore. Now it's the twin turbines. Much like the twin towers, but with less terrible things associated to it. So that could also be, like, you know, like a tourist attraction of Shitsville. The shit pipe, the mighty shit pipe. The ding-a-ling roundabout that the children just love. And the twin turbines. It's just a thing now. So, look. It's really shaping up. We still could use more houses. And now that we've fixed the electricity problem, we should be fine putting some more down. So let's do that. Let's put like half the block down. And it still says that we could use more industry as well. So let's go ahead and do that also. Fill in a little more here. Now the industry areas tend to get very crowded very fast. So I think once this starts to fill up, we might have to think about bypassing a road or two. But for now, we are definitely okay. Everything looks pretty good. Gosh, what else do we have here? All the factories and... What's this one right here? Frank's Fish Stick Factory. You know, I guess if you wanted to make, like, fish stick tacos, you could do that. I seen somebody make a fish stick sandwich once, which, to me, I gotta be honest, was a little bit off-putting. But I guess, you know, you could roll it up maybe in a corn tortilla and that could be a taco. I don't know. Has anyone ever done that? God, let me know. I need to know at this point. God, look at the residential area of Shitsville. What a beautiful place. People are just parking their cars everywhere. You know, even though they have driveways, they don't care. No one gives a shit. They're parking in the grass, on people's lawns. It's probably this guy right here who's done it. Olivia Blackwell, I know it's your fault. Where did you park? Let's see. Do you even have a car? Maybe you parked it all the way down here? Maybe you're just walking somewhere. That's fine too. Oh my goodness. No, they're walking a Burger King is what it is. She really just wants to have it her way. And that's fine, Olivia, as long as you didn't add to this parking conundrum that we seem to have here. No one parks in their driveways, but that's all right. It's residential. I'll let them do whatever they want. Oh, it looks like we need a little more commercial. So let's do that. Let's line up a little more here and see what we get. I'm excited. Now, I did add like a Pollo Hernando's thing from the Steam Workshop because that was really the only Mexican shop I could find. I really would like a taco kind of stand, but no one's made one yet. So here's hoping that in the future, someone will make one. Let's see what we got. God, look at this. We've got two Burger Kings. I don't know if that's really necessary, actually, so I'm going to bulldoze this. Because does one street really need two Burger Kings? I don't think so. If you bulldoze it, it should come back as something else. So we can see if that... Oh, look! We've had our first goal. We reached a population of 500. We are now officially a little hamlet. We can place an elementary school now, a medical clinic, and trash services. Oh, wow. We can also look at taxes and loans. So let's do that really quickly. And you can see our money has shot up quite a bit because we have so many people moving into Shitsville. Isn't that great? Now, it looks like we have another kind of a grocery store and a Big Bite. Now, that's not Burger King, so I'll leave it there. You know, because Big Bite might be different. Maybe they sell different things other than just burgers. Whatever it is, you obviously have to open your mouth really wide to accommodate it. So let's get us some services here, like trash. Now, I usually try to put the trash somewhere in the area of wherever, you know, your industrial is. Now, keep in mind, it takes up a lot of space, and it also is going to pollute like crazy. So let's go ahead and put it here. You also want it somewhere where it can easily kind of get to everywhere you need, because everywhere has trash pickup. Look at this already. Right here. Ready to bean. They've already got an overflow of bean garbage. Just like the shells and the byproducts from cooking the beans is just all over the place. Like, they have nothing. They have nowhere to put it. So look. Look at this. The garbage trucks, they're already coming out. And they're going to go to every place, including the residential, and pick up everybody's garbage automatically. Isn't that amazing? What a wonderful thing. Now, I think we actually have room now to start making a little bit more road. I think we actually should do that. Maybe expand just a little. I think now we can take down these power lines, actually, because we have a connection by way of the commercial here. So I think these can go. Don't really get a refund on those, which kind of sucks, but whatever. So we can extend the commercial area maybe out here. And then we could make some more residential areas right here. Let's make like a windy road like that I was talking about before that I really like to draw, these like little windy things. Look at this. So now, like, if you go in small increments, you can make like, look at that. Like these charming little kind of cul-de-sac-y windy roads. We could actually do that if we wanted to. We could make like a little cul-de-sac right here. Well, maybe not a cul-de-sac per se, but like a shifty little windy road. Now, this kind of takes up a lot of space when you do them like this. So if you're like a person that's into their grids when they're building cities, that's fine. There's a lot of grid purists out there, but sometimes I like to have just, what is this road that I've just constructed? It's very strange. There we go. Now, that looks fine. You know, sometimes things are a little chaotic in life, and it's all right to have them that way. So that's good. Let's go ahead and more residential, because that's what we're looking for. The demand is very high, and we can now place the school. So let's think about where we would like to put that. I kind of like to put the elementary school somewhere directly in the neighborhood so children can easily get to it from where they are. So let's go ahead and place the school. It's right here under the education tab. Elementary school. It costs 10,000 big ones. Ooh, that's going to be really expensive for right now. But they really should have a school, shouldn't they? Or we could place the medical center, which might be actually more important. Again, another $10,000, but possibly worth it for the health. Let's go ahead and make them healthy before we educate them. It's a little bit all right if they're a little bit dumb. Let's just be honest. We can put that like right here on the corner so people can access it easily. Oh, and look how happy everybody was because we did that. So now we're just gonna have to wait for people to move in, pay their rent, so we can get a school and move on. Look at that. The Schittsville Medical Clinic, where you can get all of your bowel problems looked at right away. Also, you know, any kind of itching or rashes that you might have from living so close to the Schitt's pipe can be addressed at the clinic. Wow, look at, isn't this beautiful, you guys? Look at this beautiful little town we've created. This is so great. I'm really enjoying this game. So this has been a little kind of one-night stand with City Skylines. If you guys would like us to continue on with Schittsville and keep going and see how far we can kind of take it, let me know in the comments because I would really like to play this for you even more. And if we do make a small series out of it, you know, we can just go as far as we like until we either get bored with it or, you know, the town just blows up in a terrible cataclysm of pinto beans and shit. You know, and let me know in the comments, and hopefully we'll see you next time with Schittsville. Oh, God. Isn't it lovely, this? God, it's so good.